Hey everybody, this is Nick. Today I'm going to show you how to make a United States map out of those zip code lists that we've been analyzing in previous videos. Make sure to check out those videos for how we analyzed our lists of zip codes so that we could summarize them with a pivot table and figure out how many of our visitors were from in-state, out-of-state, and international. Now the thing is, inside of Excel, if I wanted to get a heat map or a choropleth map of the United States to represent where my visitors were from that were not international, of course, we would go ahead, highlight everything in our pivot table. We'll go up to the Insert tab, and over on the chart menu, you can see that we have a maps type. Let's go ahead and click on that and click on Filled Map. But then you'll get this notification that says you can't create this chart type with data inside a pivot table. So we're going to say OK. So what we need to do is copy these data. So with everything here highlighted, just go ahead, Control C. We're going to go ahead, and what we're going to do is push Shift, Control, and V, and that's going to paste just the values. Now we see that our international here. We don't want that international data on our map, because that's not going to mean anything to Excel. So I'm going to go ahead and just delete that. I'm going to highlight everything from my state list below and just drag it on up. So it's a nice contiguous list right here. Let's highlight this list here, our counts, the number of people who are from those places, and our state values here. We'll go to the Insert tab, click on Maps, and then we'll go ahead and insert this map. Now it gives you a beautiful, nice little heat map or a choropleth map of the United States. You can see obviously the majority of our visitors are from Colorado, and then we have other states represented in very small quantities. So you can actually see up here, it gives you a series color list from one person all the way up to 816. That was our maximum, and the color value is very, very low. If I went over here, what we could do, we could edit a few of these things. So what I'm going to do is open the Format Data Series menu, and you can see it over here on the right, and you can see we have options here. There are very few options in Excel for the maps, but we have map projection, map area, map labels, and then series color. We can update this sequentially. You could also do a diverging color palette if you wanted to. This isn't necessarily diverging data, so I'm going to go back to sequential. And then maybe let's just put in, if I add that white, then you can see most of the states become kind of white, just because, you know, most of our states other than Colorado don't have more than a handful of things represented here. The thing that you can't do is you can't add direct number labels. Now, if you hover over it, you can see the little tooltips here. They kind of pop up and show you that. But if you're not in Excel, if you're in a PDF report or something like that, you're not going to be able to see those labels. So the thing is, if you click on a state, usually, I would think that you could right-click and say Add Data Label, but that option is grayed out for these maps. If you go over to the Map Label option, we could say Best Fit Only or Show All, and I thought that would give us data labels, but it actually just gives us the state names, and that's for Best Fit Only. You see a bunch of states are kind of omitted because the labels don't actually fit into the state. So you can include those if you want to, but I think maybe in this case, it'll be nice to just keep them out. I'm probably also going to just get rid of my chart title. And you can see that it has this little powered by Bing notation down here. You can barely see it, but I don't want it. It's part of the map, but they don't allow you to delete it. So I'll show you a trick if you stay tuned to the very end on how we can get rid of that little notation right there. But let's go back to our Format Data Series and see all these other options. So under Map Projection, this is the automatic treatment for the map, but you can see there are also different like visual projections for the map. You can see it sort of folds the map just a little bit. It kind of treats it just a little bit differently depending on the type of map projection that you want to use. So that looks like the Albers, looks like the automatic projection to me. The map area you can also choose. So automatic is going to be whatever data Excel thinks your map is encompassing. And so right now, Excel knows that I'm really just looking at United States, so it gave me a United States map right away. But if I wanted to say only the regions with data, I could do that, and then all of the states with no data represented would be removed from that map. You could also say country and region. That would give back to the United States. We could also say multiple countries and region. That's going to give me the entire continent of North America. And then we could also say a world, and that's going to give us the entire world map with just the United States there in that heat map or choropleth treatment, because that's the only pieces of data that we have right there. So Some pretty cool options there. I'll go back to automatic. Now, I told you I wanted to show you how you could get rid of this little notation here. The only way to do that is to copy it and paste it in as a picture, but we're gonna paste it in as an SVG, a scalable vector graphic. And when you do that, you can ungroup everything into its component shapes and delete everything, including and delete those things, including text that you don't want anymore. So all you need to do is we're going to copy this map. Down here, we're going to paste it, but instead of just paste, we're going to go to the paste special menu. And here, I want to say picture SVG. So I'll say that, and then I'll click on OK. Let's scroll down here. Now you can see it's a picture, so now I can't edit this map. So make sure that your map is perfect before you do this. What we're going to do is we are going to now right-click this and say, go to the group tab and say ungroup. We're going to have to do this a few times. Just click yes to that first message that pops up. Then I'm going to ungroup it again. And we're going to ungroup it one more time. And now you can see it's all in its complete component shapes, including a few background layers that are just white here. So if I click on this background right here, that's actually just one big white square. And I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. And we can go ahead and delete this other background right here. That's the plot area. And now if I go down here and I click on these little annotations, I can actually just get rid of those. Those are just text boxes. So I'm sorry to say that, Microsoft and Bing, but if you don't want those little powered by Bing and Microsoft labels down here in your map, this is one way to get rid of it once you've completed your map altogether. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you all have a great day, and I can't wait to see you all next time.